for each between each others, except those who love Allah and then they fear Him, and they gather because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He already mentioned in Hadith al-Qudsi, وَمَنْ اِجْتَمَعَ قَوْمٌ فِي بَيْتٍ مِنْ بُيُوتِ اللَّهِ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَهُ وَيَتَدَارَسُونَهُ بَيْنَهُمْ إِلَّا نَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ سَكِينَةٌ وَغَشِيَتْهُمْ رَحْمَةٌ وَحَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهُ. Allah, He mentioned in Hadith al-Qudsi, whoever gathered in the one of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ, they recite in His book, وَيَتَدَارَسُونَهُ بَيْنَهُمْ, and then they want to understand the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِلَّا نَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهُمُ السَّكِينَةُ, if that the case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send the sakina, the tranquility. وَغَشِيَتُمْ رَحْمًا, and then His mercy will cover us or will shower us. And then today, to work day and night, to gather this money and then deliver it to your bank, or transfer it to your bank, or transfer it to your country, or trying to build a big house, or fancy house, or legacy cars, and all this stuff, can give you a tranquility heart. Mm-hmm. What can give you tranquility? That what we have to look for. Because there is many millions who have billions, and then they don't have no tranquility in their heart. Even sometime they kill themselves. But the tranquility, only one thing can give you that tranquility. What it is? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentioned in Quran, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. To mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is the only one thing that can give you tranquility. Other than that, no way, you're not going to get it. Because he's the one who created you, and then He knows you more than you know yourself. And then He knows what is good for you, and then what is bad for you. And then he prevent you from all the bad things, but He opened the door for the all good things for you. That's why He sent our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This earth is not we the first people to live in the face of this earth, of this planet. They said, the scholar said, there is some creation before us. They name Hinnu and Bennu, and then the Jinnu, then the Malaikatu, then the Father Adam alayhi salam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all this creation, they mischief in the face of the earth. That is why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanna create Sayyidina Adam, He asked the angels, إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً قَالُوا أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءُ وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ قَالَ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentioned to angels, I will create my Khalifa in the face of earth. And then the Malaika, they respond back, أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا. You will create a people who they go into mischief on the earth, and then they go into shed the blood. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentioned, إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ, I know some that you don't know. And then وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He taught Adam all the names. That why He lift him up, and then He asked all the angels to prostrate to Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, except the shaitan. He said, no, I'm not going to do it. Why are you not going to do it, Iblis? He said, I am better than him. خَلَقْتَنِي مِن نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِن طِينٍ. You create me from the fire, and then you create him from the clay. Then, so I am better than him. But that doesn't mean nothing. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you to do something, doesn't matter what you're going to do. What does it matter? The command, where this come from? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He asked us to fast this month. As the hadith narrated by Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, or Abi Huraira, بني الإسلام على خمس شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وصوم رمضان وحج البيت لمن استطاع إليه سبيلا. These are the five pillars of Islam. And then we accept there is no God but Him. He's the only one who is capable of doing all things. Some of them you can imagine and some of them you can't. He's capable of doing all things. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentioned in the Quran al-Karim, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He can accept all the sins except one. If you assassinate any God next to Him. That's why we say, لا إله إلا الله. There is no God but Him. And then Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last messenger from Him. We accept Him, and then we accept His messenger. And then we accept that we're going to pray every day, five times. And in the five time prayer, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned in the hadith, he said, if you have a river next to your door, and then you take a shower, or you're swimming in that river every day, five times, is there any dirt when touch to your skin? No. So that means it's a five time prayers. If you make them at the time, the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you to do, we will take away your all sins. But sometime we don't have time for making our prayers. We have time running behind this dunya. And in this dunya, those who run behind it before us, they are in the grave today. Very soon, we're going to that grave. And then we know that if you open an account and then you don't work, you don't have direct deposits, you know that you cannot withdraw any penny in that account, even if you open it. You can do nothing with that account. You have to work, and then you have to make direct deposit, or you have to put some money, then you can use your card. Without that, you can't use your card. It will decline every time you use it. The same thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He don't joke. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He don't play. As He mentioned in the Quran, أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا. Do you think I created you and bring you to this earth for a play? No. It's very serious. It's very matter serious. We have to focus why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent His beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah, if He wants, He can choose all of us to be animal walking. If he wants, he will not allow us to attend to this ummah or to be among the ummah to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But those who before us, they didn't do right. That's why Allah promised, I will bring those who are going to love me and then I'm going to love them. Who are those people? Allah mentioned them in the Quran. فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ أَذِلَّةٌ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَعِزَّةٌ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, I will bring a nation who are going to love me and then I'm going to love them. Even Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be one of those, one of the ummah to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then we are among his ummah without asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What we should do? What we should do? We should not just run behind this dunya. Our kids, they don't know nothing about the Quran. Our kids, they don't know nothing about Muhammad except his name. Our kids, they don't know nothing about the family of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is not right. We have to think. This life is only time we go to pass it, and then it's done. If you look at ourselves when we come to this dunya, we were very, very, very small. We don't know our names. We don't know our fathers. We don't know our uncles. We don't know nothing. We don't know what the money for. What does money mean? We just know crying. We just come in crying in this life. And then if we don't do right, what we're supposed to do, one day we're going to pass, and our family, they will cry behind us. But what we're going to face, that is a matter. They don't know what is gonna happen to you. They're just gonna cry, and that is gonna, it's not gonna take long. It's only be 2 days, 3 days, and it's done. What's gonna happen to your money? They're gonna come and share it. Your kids, they're going to fight. And then your wife, your own wife, somebody else will come and take it. Your own bed. Somebody else will come and lay down there, and what you can do? Nothing. And then you are facing in something in your grave. We don't know. We should work for it. We know whatever we do, we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's capable of rewarding. If you do one good, Allah, He will multiply it 10 times. One bad is only V1. And then whenever you return back and ask Him forgiveness, He will forgive you. And in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned in a hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ تَوْبَةَ الْعَبْدِ مَا لَمْ يُغَرْغِرْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept the repentance of His servant unless he's not close to the death. If you are close to the death and then you see it, you're going to regret, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He don't want it from you. This is the time to do it. This is the right time. You are healthy and you don't have no problem. You can do anything, and then you have strength enough to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is your time. When you get weak, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He don't need you. There is a scholar, he used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during his youth. And then the people saw him. He's getting old, but he still having strength. And then they ask him, why? How do you get this strength? He said, when I was young, I take all of my strength and give it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I get old, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He give me His strength. Oh. That is the how we deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah is very mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very kind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who's the one, even if no one care about you, know there is someone who care about you, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who's the one, if all the creation, they left you, no, he will never let you down. So we should not do what He don't ask us to do. We're supposed to do what He ask us, what He command us to do. And then we say, all we love our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Even this little kid, if you ask him, do you love the Prophet Muhammad? Of course he will tell you yes, and then he will respond back to me, why do you ask me this question? And then you know that the answer was going to be yes. So why we should not teach him who's your prophet? That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned in the hadith what he said, عَلِّمُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ ثَلَاثَةَ خِصَالِ حُبُّ نَبِيَّكُمْ وَحُبُّ آلِ بَيْتِهِ وَحُبُّ الْقُرْآنِ. We have to taught our kids three things. How to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then how to love his family, Ahlul Bayt, Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. And then how to love the Quran. Quran is a light. We know that Musa alayhi salam, he spoke with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know. وَمَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينِكَ يَا مُوسَى قَالَ هِيَ عَصَايَ أَتَوَكَّوُ عَلَيْهَا وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَى غَنَمِي وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَآرِبُ أُخْرَى قَالَ أَلْقِهَا يَا مُوسَى فَأَلْقَاهَا فَإِذَا هِيَ حَيَّةٌ تَسْعَى قَالَ خُذْهَا وَلَا تَخَفْ سَنُعِيدُهَا سِيرَتَهَا الْأُولَى. This is a conversation between Sayyidina Musa and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we want speak with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We want to enter to paradise with our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We want to be with him in this life. We want to be with him in the life after. So why we say all this? And in the Quran, with us, we don't have time even to read one chapter. It's shame to us. We don't have time even to sit with our kids sometimes just to teach them, even if you don't know, just open the Quran, even if you just know one harf, one ayah, just repeat it with your kids. You will have the hasanat from that ayah. Just alif lam mim, you don't know nothing, just alif lam mim. Just repeat it with your kids that you can gain this hasanat. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned in hadith, alifun harfun, walamun harfun, and wa harfun bi'ashra hasanat. One harf, you gain one ashra hasanat. Alif is a harf. Lam harfun, mim harfun. This is a three harf. Together, alif, lam, mim, that is a ten hasanat. Right away. Sometimes you just sit with your kids. Alif, lam, mim, just repeat it five times, two times. How many hasanat do you get there? It's better than wasting the time watching the basketball, watching the movies, walking the street, wasting our time. This time is gone. And then whenever the time is gone, we cannot repeat it back. It's already counted in your life. And then when we passed away, they will put such and such, and then they put little dash and such and such. That little dash, that is our life. It's very short. It's not going to be long line. It's a very short line. That is our life. We have to think. This is only a reminder. Because of the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he asks us to remind each others. فَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. We have to remind each others. We have to remind sometime why we are here. We have to remind the step, the footstep of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We always say we love him. And then we all, before him, we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah, he mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned in hadith, he mentioned in the Quran, if you say so that you love me, what do you have to do? You have to go and gather the dunya. You have to go and work day and night. You have to, what do you have to do? He asks you only one thing, to follow the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you command that you love him, if you say so that you love him, then follow the footsteps of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Other than that, you just say so. And then we are in very blessing month. The months that Allah mentioned in the Quran, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr, wa ma adraka ma laylatul qadr, laylatul qadri khayrun min alfi shahr. Ramadan is blessing month. And then there is a night that is better than 1,000 months. Sometimes even we can't live in this life 1,000 months. Sometimes even we don't reach maybe 500 months. But you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one night, and then you seem like you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in 1,000 months. If you cannot find this in any ummah except the ummah to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we are very blessed. And in this month is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed all the Holy Quran. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil mubarakah. Very blessing night and in very blessing month. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to fast not only Ramadan, but he used the most of the months that he used to fast is 2 months. Sha'ban and then Muharram. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned in hadith, Rajab shahrullah wa sha'banu shahri wa ramadanu shahru ummati. He said that Rajab is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the Sha'ban is my month. And then the Ramadan is for my ummah. It's not only for the ummah that should do action, more deep in this month. If you don't read the Quran, try to read more Quran in this month. If you don't give charity, try to do it in this month. If you don't visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, try to do it in this month. If you don't visit your neighbors, try to do it in this month. If you don't do any good, try to do it in this month. I'm just reminding you and remind myself. And trying to read the Quran. If you don't do much prayer, try to do it. Make it up in this prayer in this month. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the end of the last ten days, he used to wrapped up himself, and he left his wife and everything, and then went to the masjid doing his i'tikaf until the end of the month. And then awwaluhu maghfira wa awsatuhu rahma wa akhiruhu itqu min an-nar awwaluhu rahma. The first 10 days is a rahmah. And the second 10 days is a maghfirah. Forgiveness. And then the last 10 days, itqun min an-nar, that Allah persecuted you from the hellfire. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala persecuted all of us from the hellfire. Amen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our deeds in this month.
Amen.
May Allah increase our salat in this month.
Amen.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be among the ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The ummah that he mentioned in the Quran, kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas ta'muruna bil ma'ruf wa tanhawna 'anil munkar wa tu'minuna billah. This dunya, we just gonna pass. We just have to take care of what we have to take care of. But we should not give all our time to this dunya. Just give it some time for your work and for your family. But don't forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't forget to send more salutation upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I don't ask you to do it. Allah is the one who asks you to do so. He's the one who asks you, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتُهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. Try to mention Allah's name much as you can. I didn't ask you to do so. Allah is the one who asks you to do it. وَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. There's a scholar, he was sitting in front of his students. And then he tells them, I know when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned my name. And then the student, they look at him like he's a liar. How do you know that? Is a ghaif, is unseen. How do you know that? And then no one says nothing, but that what they put in their mind and what they thought. And then the scholar asked them, I know there is some doubt in your mind, but I will make it clear to you. Do Allah mention in Quran, "Fadhkuruni azkurkum"? Do Allah mention in Quran, if he mention me, I will mention you? Then I know that whenever I start mentioning him, he mentioned me. That is simple, easy. So, if you want Allah to mention you, just mention Him. Because if He don't want you to mention Him, He will not allow your tongue to mention His name. There is many people who walk, they want to mention His name, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He don't bless them with His name. But Allah, He blessed us with the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He blessed us with Quran. He's blessed us with the Sahaba. He's blessed us with the scholar. He's blessed us with everything that even you know or you don't know. وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. Allah, He favored us so much. So what we have to reply back to Him? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, not only when you finish your drink, you say Alhamdulillah, right? When you finish your eating, you say Alhamdulillah, right? But sometimes you will see struggle man. He didn't have no money. He's very struggling. And then you give him some money, you help him with his situation. You are the reason for him to say Alhamdulillah. Because he was in a situation that he will know no one to fix it. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide you to him. And then you help him. And then you will look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, Alhamdulillah that you sent someone to help me. So that means Allah, He still care about me. And then He still care about you. Because He will reward you that good deeds you do for your brother. We have to help each other more as we can. We have to do much as we can. Because whatever we do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is keeping it for us. And is waiting for us too. The family, the friends, the scholars, the house, the cars, the wives, the kids. One day all of them will be behind. And then you're going to face your deeds. I will finish with this two stories. And then there is a young man. He went out and then he saw a very beautiful woman. And then he engaged with her and then he went to marry. He went for marry and they asked him, hey, if you want to marry our daughter, you have to bring your father. And then the boy, he said, that is no problem. He went, he asked his father to come with him. And then the father come. When he looked at the girl, he said, oh son, this girl is not for you, this is for me. And then the son tell him, father, I can let everything go, but this one, I'm not going to let it go. And then they have a problem, and then they go to the police station. And then, you know, the man come, he said, what's the problem? He said, what happened? And then he said, okay, this lady is not for you, it's not for you, this for me. They said, no, we're not going to let it go. And then they go through the minister. And then the minister said, this is for me. Until they go to the king. And then when everyone come in front of the king, and then the king said, oh, yes, this is only for the kings. I'm going to take it. And everybody said, no, you're not going to take it from us. And then they start shouting. And then, you know, the girl said, okay, you know, it's no problem. I'm going to run. And whoever touched me first, then I'm going to marry you. And then the girl, she ran away. And everyone followed the girl. Until the girl come to very, very big hall. And then she jumped. And everybody drowned in that hall. You know what does that mean? We run behind the dunya until we visit our graves. We didn't get the dunya, either we didn't get the akhirah. If we look at that smart way, we're not going to let this dunya to mischief us. Or to let us go without nothing. And then we want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessing. We want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. And then we want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward us. And then there is a man. This is a story, I'm going to close it. The man, both of them are scholar, or they are the wali. Both of them are wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are the holy man of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Both of them. One of them used to be the imam. And then the other one, he used to pray behind the imam. The one who used to pray behind the imam, he passed away. But before he passed away, he wrote a will. And then he left it in one of his friends. What he wrote there, he said, when I passed away, I don't want the imam to pray in my janazah. That is what he said. He said, Assalamu alaikum. And then he told the man with the reason why. And then the man, he passed away, and then they bring him in front of everyone. And then the imam, he come, you know, he's supposed to do the janazah, but the man came to him and show him the letter. He said, the man said, he don't want you to pray in his janazah. And then he get shocked. He said, what's the problem? This man, he is very close friend to me. And then he used to pray behind me. And then what happened? What's the problem? He asked himself. And then he cannot get the results. And when everything done, he returned back to the same man and asked him. He said, can you tell me what the reason why the man, he don't want me to pray with his janazah? He said, I can tell you what he tell me. He said, you are not forgiven. You are not forgiving person. Whoever do bad to you, you will return it back to him. And then where he going? He looking for mercy. He looking for peace. And then he don't look for someone who fight or someone who don't forgive. He said he's not looking for that. That's why he said he don't want you to pray in his janazah. And then the man, the imam, he returned back all the houses that he have a problem with them and ask them forgiveness. Mm. So this is the blessing months that we should ask each other to forgiveness. Mm. And then we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. Mm. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us.
Ameen.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us
Ameen.
From the shaitan.
Ameen.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from hellfire.
Ameen.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the punishment of grave.
Ameen.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us be among those who are going to drink with the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the river of Kawthar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be our shafa'a. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let us be real among the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. بحق سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وآله وسلم وبسر يا أكرم الخلق ما لي من ألوذ به سواك عند حلول حادث عممي ولم يضيق رسول الله جاهك بي إذا الكريم تجلى باسم منتقم فإن من جودك دنيا وذرتها ومن علومك علم اللوح والقلم يا نفس لا تقنتي من زلة عظمت إن الكبائر في الغفران كالممي لعل رحمة ربي حين يقسمها تأتي على حسب العصيان في القسم يا ربي واجعل رجائي غير منعكس لديك واجعل حسابي غير منقرم وطب عبدك في الدارين إن له صبرا متى تداو الأهوال ينهزم وأذن لصحب صلاة منك دائمة على نبي بمنهل ومنسجم ما رنحت عزبات بان ريح الصبا وأطرب عيسى حادي عيسى بالنقم ثم رضا عن أبي بكر وعن عمر وعن علي وعن عثمان وعنا جميعا وآلي وصحب ثم تابعين فهم أهل التقى والنقى والعلم والكرم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع